Hello everyone, this is Rohit Surisetti and along with me I have my friend Manoj Chandra, and today's guest is Mr. Arun Karthik KV, who is a former CSK and RCB player. Hello sir, and welcome to our show.
Hi Rohit, thanks for the intro.
Hello sir, myself Manoj, how are you doing sir?
Hi Manoj, hi, I'm good Manoj, how are you doing? Good to see you guys.
Yes sir, I'm doing perfect. Sir, my first question is, how and when did your passion start towards cricket, and tell us something about your journey.
I'm from a place called Vellore, you guys might have known. Vellore is famous for VAT college and then Vellore jail. So I'm from a place called Vellore, that's my district in Tamil Nadu. So I started as a district cricketer, and then from then on I went on to play for Tamil Nadu under 19th and 8th categories, and then from then I went on to play for Ranji Trophy, and then for CSK and RCB, and I've been playing. So that's my beginning, and I come from a small town called Valajapet, so it's in the Vellore district. So that's the beginning.
Yes, sir. Sir, as in the journey of any cricketer, let's say like Virat Kohli or MS Dhoni, or let's say anyone cricketer, success and failure are both as common as something like failure. Sir. So, how do you manage your success and failure quotient in your life?
It's just not cricket. Anything you do in life, anything you want to achieve in life, there will be lots of downs rather than ups. I mean, we live for that moment. I mean, the kind of you have to accept that there will be downs in your life, and then there will also be ups in your life. So you have to take both in equal terms, and you have to learn from everything, even in your up. You should not get over excited, or you should not be over. Overconfident about yourself, and then lose it out. It's better, and it's the best thing to do is stay equanimous, equal to whatever we are doing, and that's what I have learned from cricket.
Sir,
yes,
my question
stay
is, humbled. Sir, having played big tournaments of the nation like IPL, TNPL, and Ranji Trophy, which platform do you think that it is a better opportunity for the youngsters to showcase their talents?
I feel both Ranji Trophy and IPL is very, very crucial for somebody to go on to play to the next level. I mean, IPL is such platform. It has produced great players like for the country. Like Jasprit Bumrah, Hardik Pandya, and lots of players. And equally, Ranji Trophy is very, very important because it's a longer format, and it tests your character. Ranji Trophy really tests your character. And a guy who performs really well in Ranji Trophy and who has a good IPL, he has a great chance of making the country. So that's how I look at it.
Yes, sir. Sir, having being played under MS Dhoni, sir, for CSK, what special qualities do you think he possesses in order to become his successful as a captain and as a person, sir? What special qualities do you think?
I mean, there are many people have spoken about Dhoni, and everyone knows that his calmness is his strength. In how he handles crunch situation, how he handles big matches, is what his MS Dhoni is known for, and that is his greatest quality. We have seen many, many great players not doing well in the important games, crucial games, and I think where MS Dhoni stands apart from everyone is how he handles that important game, important. He handles everything beautifully. important situations with calmness and composure. I think that is his greatest quality. And obviously his leadership skills, nobody can match his leadership skills. He is someone who treats you as a friend and brings the best out of you. That's again one more great quality of MS. That's what I feel.
Yes.
Sir, tell us something about the match where you won for your team, the team RCB, by hitting the last ball six against the Redbacks team. What was going through the mind, through your mind actually at the last ball?
It question I've answered many times. I mean, my followers or my friends would have got bored about this question, but still, I think that is one memory which will last me forever. It's a beautiful moment. It's a moment to cherish for me. I can say that what was going through my mind was my mind was blank at that moment. I would say that is the most important thing that happened for me, was that my mind was blank. I was not thinking too far ahead what will happen if I score that six runs. Or I didn't think that what will happen if I was not able to score that. The mind was blank. That I was blessed to be blank at that moment, so that I was able to watch the ball clearly and hit the shot. That was the only thing that was going through my mind. And the preparation part was very, very important going into that tournament. I prepared really well, and my body language and my confidence was also very good in that. Yeah.
Yes, sir. And sir, how's your experience playing alongside with world's top class batsmen like Virat Kohli, AB de Villiers, and Chris Gayle when you played for RCB, sir? And can you share some of your memorable moments with them, sir?
Yeah, I mean, it was great sharing experience. I mean, sharing dressing room with such great players and learning a lot from them, especially from Virat Kohli. And because Virat Kohli was a great player, I mean, he was a good talent at that time. But he was not what Virat Kohli now is. His fitness levels were okay, and he was just learning about training at that time, and his transformation happened at that time when I was there. So I was very fortunate to see him coming up the ladder, and I learned a lot from him because his self confidence is in different level self confidence. It's something it's born in him. I mean, the match which we won, that the Champions League game, chasing 215 or something, while we came after the first inning, he told in the dressing room that it can be chased, and we should start believing in that. So that kind of self-confidence what he had in him and the team, I think that is what Virat Kohli is, and that is what I learned a lot. And his belief itself is very, very, how can you say it? It's magical. It's magical. He believes in him. He believes in miracles. He believes in, that's why he's a beautiful chaser. He chases big, big scores with ease. That's because he believes he has that formula to succeed. I think that's what I learned from Virat Kohli. Yes, obviously, AB de Villiers, with so much talent, with so much thing around him, he stays very, very humble. He's very, very approachable. You can go and talk to him. You can go and ask any advice or anything to him. He's very, very open, and he just enjoys his life. He just lives his life. So that's about it. And Chris Gayle. We all know what kind of character he is. He's just fun to be around, and he's he is someone who lights up the dressing room. He is someone who lights up, brings smiles to the people. So he's that kind of character. So I was very, very fortunate to being part of the dressing room.
Yes.
Sir, how do you manage with both the physical fitness and the mental stamina together, and how do you prepare yourself for the match?
I believe over the years I have played, physical fitness is very, very important, and equally important is your mental fitness. You have to be at your best. You need to think well. You need to be around good people, and then you need to be in good space for you to go out there and perform. And especially during this quarantine time, I mean this lockdown period, very, very important for you to accept what the situation is, rather than fighting the situation. And it's the same with cricket. Sometimes, like you said, there will be ups and downs. You need to accept whatever the situation is, whatever is happening around you. You need to accept. Then you will find that peace inside you, and that will give you that calmness. That will give you that calmness to go there and perform. That's what I believe. Acceptance, and then wherever you have to be grateful. To wherever you are, and if you are grateful, you will be very, very happy. I think that's one mental aspect. As cricketers, we need to, as cricketers or any being, we have to practice. I think that's a magical emotion, gratitude.
Yes, sir. And as everywhere, the current buzz is about the IPL 2020, sir. So what are your views on this IPL 2020 in UAE, and which teams do you think will make it into the top four, sir?
First and foremost, hats off to BCCI for organizing IPL in this pandemic. And
yes.
There are a lot of things happening around the world right now, and even during this pandemic, their efforts of efforts to make this tournament happen itself is a great effort. And then I mean, it's not the matter of who is going to win or lose or whatever it is. I think the best team will definitely going to win, but the tournament happening itself is it's history in the make. So I think hats off to the organizers. Unbelievable. And especially during this period, people need some entertainment. Because there's been lot of things happening around. People need some entertainment. People need that excitement. So I think it's great IPL is happening.
Yes, sir.
Sir, what was your take on cricket after this pandemic? What effect would it have on the game?
Definitely there will be a lot of changes in after pandemic. I mean, it's cricket, or like even life is not going to be the same after the pandemic. It will take a few years together to get you need to maintain the social distancing. And then you can't go around just like how we used to go around. So cricket, definitely it will take some time to especially the physical body after so much of gap, it will take at least few weeks together to get your body going. And then definitely the normal is, this is going to be the new normal, at least for the time being, till we get the vaccines ready. I think it's going to be exciting. I mean, how it's going to pan out, we have to wait and see.
Yes, sir. Sir, tell us how is your practice and preparation during this lockdown, sir? We have seen a couple of videos practicing with Ravichandran Ashwin, sir. Can you just share a few moments about it?
One good thing about is about this lockdown is I fortunately have a decent weight with me to train, equipment, good equipment with me to train, and I'm fortunate enough to have those equipment, and I've been training very well, and whatever training I can do, I'm giving my best. And batting wise, I'm not batting so much. That was the session which I batted with Ashwin was the first session, first time I took my bat and pads out. So that was feeling little awkward for me. And he wanted to practice some. So I thought he asked me to come and bat, so I went and. We have been friends since our under 13 days. So
yes, sir, that's so great, sir. And after this pandemic, what are your future plans or dreams, sir? When the cricket resumes?
BCCI said that there will be Ranji Trophy and Syed Mushtaq Ali Trophy. My dream, I mean. I would say my mission, which I'm working on to win Ranji Trophy, that has been my dream since I started playing cricket. So I'm really focused and working on that. And then yes, I'm making an IPL comeback. That's also again a dream.
Yes. So finally, what suggestions would you like to give to the young and aspiring cricketers, sir? Watching today live.
I mean, especially after this pandemic, mental health is very, very important. I keep telling you guys, this is something it's very, very important. Once you need to find your purpose, why you are playing this game. That is very, very important, and you need to be very, very honest with yourself. If you are playing just at district level, you need to dream big. At the same time, you have to be honest with yourself. You need to if you are just in the state level, you need to dream big, but at the same time, you need to keep adding your skills. You need to be honest with yourself where you stand. And then you need to keep adding your skills level, and enjoy the game. Very, very important is to enjoy this game. So once you start enjoying this game will look very, very easy. If you start putting too much of expectation out of you, then there is a thin line between expecting or dreaming, and then. There's an thin line between over expected. So you need to find the balance, right? For that, you need to be honest. Wherever you are, just accept and then keep improving. That's what I mean.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And one last question, sir. Can you just share us your experience at Sri Lanka club, sir, playing for Sri Lanka club? And how far do you think club experience will help a player in getting into the top, sir, topmost level at the cricket?
Yeah, as a youngster, when I was 22, I went there to play first class cricket, and then that was very, very helpful for me as a cricketer, upcoming cricketer. It was very, very helpful because the standard was very, very good. I mean, throughout the Sri Lankan country, there were only 12 top teams. So that means you'll be playing very, very good quality bowlers and quality, you will be playing against good quality team. So I scored runs there as well. That gave me a lot of confidence to come back and score, play in the Ranji Trophy or any CSRA or Syed Mushtaq Ali Trophy. Because I knew that I belonged to that level. That gave me a lot of confidence that I belonged to that level. that's about it. I mean, that's very, very important. Any youngster, you have to go out and explore lots of things. So if you are so satisfied with whatever, wherever you are, then it becomes very, very difficult. You have to keep exploring. You need to travel a lot. You need to see many people. Then you will see a lot of conditions. You will make good friends there. You will explore what life is. So travel has given me a lot of confidence and belief in myself.
Yes, sir. Sir, before we end this session, we would like to have a few questions from the audience as well, sir. And here is Shahrukh Jilani, sir. His question is, what's your favorite RCB moment? Apart from that last ball six, what's your favorite moment, sir?
Yeah, I think Chris Gayle 175 was I think the way he started that innings and the way he finished, unbelievable. The word though, he was smashing the bowlers all over, and that's unbelievable. That was one of my favorite RCB moments.
Yes. Thank you so much for spending your valuable time with us, sir. And it was great chatting with you. And thank you so much, sir. And have a great career ahead, sir.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you, guys. Thank you, sir. Thank you. You guys also have a great career.
Yes, sir. Sure. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Bye, sir. Bye, sir.
Thank you, sir. Bye, sir.